bollocks. Been holding him awake, hasn't tried a thing. Why'd he up and bolt now? Matter of fact, got to thinking. What did a sweet, gentle chap like him do?
Without hesitation.
Tiny devils, hungry like a wolf I am.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
As you command.
Left, right, left, right.
You mad? Don't shake that!
Again and again and again. An army's a waste of time for one like me.
This could hurt.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Left, right, left, right.
If the ring won't come off, just take the whole finger.
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Scars? No, they don't hurt.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Quick and painful this'll be.
Her Majesty is exceptional.
shame to let this beauty go to waste.
Turnips back for an encore!
I only loot corpses, except sometimes. They're quite fresh.
Oh, could murder a pint.
Angren lies thousands of leagues from the sea. Yet the Imperial fleet looked chiefly to this land for wood, its ashes and oaks ideal for shipbuilding. The lumber was driven down the Yaruga to shipyards in Sintra and Atra. There, day and night, Nilfgaard's fleet grew and grew.
So when Meave heard axes steadily hacking, the continual grind of saws, she halted her force and quickly dispatched scouts. Indeed, they found a lumber camp, banners overhead, the great sun blazing upon them. Though not critical to her mission, Meave was nonetheless tempted to disrupt the invader however she could.
The Emperor awaits a mass flow of logs,
called the Queen, drawing her sword.
But we shall send him corpses! Formation! Follow me!
When the Lyrians rushed forth with a cry on their lips, the lumberjacks dropped their axes.
Lyrian!
Wise choice.
As you command.
Army's a waste of time for one like me. Left, right, left, right.
To plunder. Be gone!
Can you use this? I'm not sure if it'll work just yet, but.
Carny metals. Hungry like a wolf, I am.
Take the whole finger.
Fight for the Emperor and you might be freed!
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
To work! This could hurt. Obedience or the lash. Watch your heads! As ordered!
Naturally. At once.
Catch him! He's worth 20 florins!
Her Majesty knows what she's doing.
Nothing personal, I assure you.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Oh, be ashamed to let this beauty go waste.
Thank you. It's not too late to walk away.
Angren lies thousands away.
The Emperor awaits a map.
Saitu Naveen! Lyrian!
Wise choice.
Yes?
Order!
To plunder. Be gone!
Got any vettels? Hungry like a wolf, I am.
Left, right, left, right.
In line!
Again and again and again. Left, right, left, right.
Move! Serves a purpose.
Again and again and again.
You mad? Don't shake that!
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Fight for the Emperor and you might be free! We must trust each other!
Can you use this? I'm not sure if I'll watch it yet, but...
Thing about slings, they hide well.
Just take the whole finger.
Oh, could murder a pint.
Make love, not war.
This could hurt. This one's got spirit.
Nilfgaard's ranks folded. Soldiers fled in fright, stumbling over felled trees and corpses.
The Spratn of Alien! Retreat!
The air was heavy with the scent of resin and blood. As she caught her breath, the Queen looked about. Hundreds of trees lay cut down in rows. Oak and ash enough to keep the shipyards working till winter. Meave ordered the lumber requisitioned. Yet one of the loggers approached her. A man with a face like old leather, sawdust in his hair.
Good lady, I know you war hard against Nilfgaard. I know you'd keep timber out of their hands. But then, see, we won't get paid. We'll see no coin till Sintra's shipyard see lumber. It's what the black lads said. I beg you, have mercy. We're simple folk. Been slaving since spring, got families to feed. And hunger looms ever close in wartime.
Meave looked at the logger's hands. Thick scars, crisscrossed fingers twisted by years of axe work.
This wood I cannot allow to reach Nilfgaardian shipyards,
she said.
Yet neither can I let you go hungry. I shall take the wood and pay you from my own purse.
blisters on my hands from all this work. What? You've a big arm. You've a big arm. You've a... Got blisters. Never... Work. Work.
As you command.
My boots got sand a plenty in them.
Garny devils, hungry like a wolf I am.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Naturally. At once.
Off to the front yet again.
Left, right, left, right.
And left, right!
Again and again and again. Army's a waste of time for one like me.
Ice car? No. They don't hurt.
Feel any burning? See a local healer or white woman.
Yes?
Not supposed to be any smoke.
Left, right, left, right.
We'll catch them all!
So much anger and suffering. For what?
Scheiß in zwei!
If the ring won't come off, just take the whole finger.
Company! Forward march!
Watch your heads!
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest!
Off to the front yet again.
Again and again and again.
Ever have a storm knock out one of your teeth?
The chase is on!
Wait, you're serious?
Entering the swamp's easy. Trouble. Entering...
In the distance, Meave spotted a spindle-like shape, which soon proved an enormous, dark obelisk. It stood in the middle of a wetland clearing. Dozens of iron rings dangled from its shaft, clinking and rattling in gusts of wind. Cows, donkeys, and dogs were gathered round the stone, all tied to the rings by ropes. Their hides showed many shallow cuts, seeping blood, festering, drawing mosquitoes in swarms. A number of the animals struggled against their cords, while others, near dead, lay still in the wet, tall grass. Across the clearing, folk emerged from the woods, a handful of peasants with a mule in tow. The beast resisted, stomped, and planted its hooves, perhaps sensing its gruesome fate. The queen decided to question the peasants, and soon learned the animals were their sacrifice to the swamp gods.
They're all about, dearie. Very close. Oh, very, very close.
The toothless old woman whispered.
They hide neath murky waters. Can't feed when they hear the drip, drip of blood. The gods look kindly on those what make an offering.
I know nothing of your gods,
began the queen, her nose crinkled in disgust.
But any that demand such grisly tribute are not at all worthy of reverence. What you do to these creatures is savagery. Savagery I can't allow.
Run us off, you can,
replied the old shrew.
For as soon as you're gone, we'll come back. As ever, we'll come back.
This I know. So I must take care to leave you nought to come back to.
Over the peasants' howls and pleas, Meave ordered the obelisk brought down. Her soldiers gripped the ropes that hung from it and toppled the shaft. As it hit the ground, it shattered into many smaller pieces.
You say you know nout of our guts?
The old woman's eyes narrowed. Her voice grew darker still.
Well, don't you worry your head, sweetie. You'll meet him soon enough. They'll tangle your parts. So a pox among you's drive it to madness. Every last one. I curse you. All of you. In Gernacora's name.
Undisturbed by the Harridan's screamed threats, Meave rode on. But her men whispered long of the curse. It weighed on their minds, poisoned their hearts. Each misstep, misfortune, they saw as punishment for their sacrilege. In Angren, all decomposes, be it dead or very much alive. Rot blights trees, seeping sores torment beasts, and the whole swamp emits the acrid, stifling stench of decay. So when, in the swamp's distant corner, the Lyrians caught whiffs of smoke and roasted meat, they stopped dead in their tracks. The scouts followed their noses to a clearing framed by a palisade. Through the gaps in the posts, they spotted a small fort.
Any banners upon it? Whose do you see?
Asked the Queen.
There aren't none, Your Grace. Not one golden sun, not one silver lily.
Meave gave the gate a few solid knocks with her shield. Moments later, a dozen armed men appeared atop the rampart. The one who led them wore a beard.
Who are you? Why are you here?
I'm Meave, Queen of Lyria and Rivia. At war with Nilfgaard, I ventured into these swamps.
Is there a war on? Hey, that's news. Certainly, but little concern to me. The name's Gimpy Gerwin and I rule these lands.
Is that so? As conferred upon you by whom?
By me! Angren's a good bit larger than folk think. And no duke's or emperor's fingers stand to reach its every corner. Thus I just up and took this particular nook. Made it mine. So let's parley, Meave. One ruler to another. At the risk of being blunt, I don't care who wins this war. But I want to be in good standing with whoever does. So, I offer you a fire at which to warm your limbs. Also, a place at my table and beds for you to rest. On condition, you pledge to me one very small thing. To respect the sacred laws of hospitality.
So be it. I do solemnly swear before the gods and my ancestors that we shall honor all the laws of hospitality.
Then you're most welcome inside.
The fort was simple, built of logs, covered with thatch. Oh, but inside, it was warm, dry. Hot, steaming dishes were piled upon platters, the tables beneath them bent from their weight. Smiles appeared on her soldiers' drained faces, and Meave's spirits were lifted at last. Gerwin proved a cordial host and eagerly shared both food and tales. He'd led a mercenary band, and they'd stumbled into Angren, discovered a land unclaimed by any feudal lord. He directed the fort, then united the surrounding villages under his very own rule.
The folk here are savage, defiant,
he said, sipping wine.
I keep them on a tight lead for their own good. Elsewise, they'd slit your throat first chance they got.
Late that night, Meave went to see if her mare had been dressed. In the stable, she happened on a farmhand. Recognizing the queen, the man fell to his knees and averted his eyes. Meave noticed a strange object dangling from a rope around his neck. A human hand, half rotted to the bone.
What? What is that?
My wife's hand, your grace,
stammered the peasant.
Lord Gerwin caught a sneak in some grub. Scraps, really. Took her and told me to wear it so I'd remember what happens when... When...
Meave left the stable without uttering another word. She went straight to the servants' barracks. In the pale glow of her torch, she looked over the peasants, all terrified, all with fresh, bleeding wounds. The queen felt rage rise inside her. The queen reached for her sword, but she'd taken an oath, so her hand paused on the hilt. Gerwin was cruel, deserved to be punished. But Meave would not do the deed. The queen blew her horn, woke her men from sweet slumber. She ordered them to assemble. They would march out at once. Gerwin rushed out, confused, to ask what had happened. Meave gave no answer, save to spit at his boots.
pissing in the moat? Oh, again.
Meave stood waiting while her scouts cut through the tangled branches and roots that had overgrown the trail through the swamp. Suddenly, a soldier doubled over and began to retch blood. The same symptoms soon afflicted others in her ranks.
A potent poison,
was the medic's verdict. Happily, Isbel concocted an antidote in time to deliver the soldiers from a certain and agonizing death. Meave rode at the front, her eyes fixed on the ground, and thus spotted the pit masked by leaves and branches. She tugged hard on her reins and steered her mount to the side. Alas, the cavalryman behind her did not follow her lead.
life is mine now.
Yes?
To me, Nidloir!
Again and again and again.
Wise choice.
An army's a waste of time for one like me. Left, right, left, right. An army's a waste of time for one like me.
Can you use it? I'm not sure if I want it yet, but...
Discipline shall bring us victory!
Just take the whole finger.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Catch!
Gloire!
I smell a leak.
Serves a purpose.
Murder a pint.
Anger and suffering. For what?
This is a Seifel!
Wait, you're serious?
Heil Herta.
A highly curious case.
Retreat! Fall back!
Caught between Lyrian Hammer and Skellige Stone, Nilfgaard was shattered, destroyed. The victors now stood eyeing each other. These islanders were not like those Meave had met before. They wore no armor and carried no shields. At their fore stood a man as stout as an ox and bald as an ancient ghoul. His men called him Arnulf, the Patricide.
I thank you for your aid, Arnulf,
said Meave, extending a hand.
Aid, she says. Aid? Do you hear that, mates?
The Skelligers exchanged glances, then erupted in roaring laughter.
Not here to help yous, not at all. We're after killing.
Join me and you shall have your fill.
Join nuisance? Just who the hell are you?
Meave, Queen of Rivia and Lyria.
Meave?
Arnulf said, his tone sobering.
I know the name. Lippy Goodman called ye bold. Praised your courage to the high heaven. So be it. We'll follow ye into fire, wench. Just let us taste of blood. Grant us a death worthy of heroes.
Meave couldn't help but smile, then nodded to accept. The Lyrians stepped aside as tattooed warriors joined their ranks. The scouts rode at the fore, with Meave right behind them. Their task, to find safe passage for the rest of the force. One among them probed for the quagmire's depth, a pole of five ells in hand. Suddenly, all heard a loud clang. The scouts dismounted, then heaved a bronze statue from the mire. Once it was cleaned of slime and muck, Meave instantly recognized its elven handiwork. The sculpture was exceedingly well preserved, save one detail. Someone had removed its face, leaving a black hole in its stead.
Search the environs,
ordered Meave. Amongst some brambles, they discovered the entrance to a vast tomb. Its doors had been torn open. On the ground before them lay scattered bones, some yellowed with age, others fresh, cracked and tattered from having been gnawed. Meave stood silent and contemplating at the tomb's threshold. Then, torch in hand, she entered and waded into fetid waters. Her soldiers followed close, arms at the ready, a nervous sweat on their brows. Frescoes on the tomb walls depicted Angren swamps and the beasts that prowled them. Two words were inscribed over the largest of the horrors. Gvern Iker.
The bloody mistress,
Barnabas Beckenbauer whispered. Suddenly, a roar thundered from deeper inside the tomb. Meave turned from the frescoes to see monstrous eyes blazing in the dark.
Without hesitation.
Everywhere we go, it's dark and wet.
Again.
The chase is on!
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Naturally. At once.
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Ha!
Left, right, left, right.
My pain serves a purpose.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
May the Scrias hands here! Time I wiped it away!
Left, right, left, right.
Nothing personal, I assure you.
Watch your heads!
The day?
Think I'm a bear!
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Yes?
Give me some of that.
Waiting for a personal invitation.
Don't need no weapon.
Ha!
Army's waste of time for one like me. Left, right.
Feel
left.
Any burning? See a local healer or wise woman.
Watch your heads!
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Ah! Again and again and again.
Nothing personal, I assure you.
All right, that's no problem.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
The chase is on!
Not supposed to be any smoke.
We must trust each other.
I live to serve you.
It's not too late to walk away.
I only need corpses. Except sometimes, they're quite fresh.
We shall achieve our goal. Naturally. At once.
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Come on, kill me!
Arm is a waste of time for one like me.
I smell a leak.
An army's a waste of time for one like me.
That bit's the white of an eye from half a league away.
Has today the day?
Thank you.
Yes?
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Again and again and again. Army's a waste of time for one like me.
Watch your heads!
Has today the day?
One man's battlefield is another man's ripe patch for harvest.
Ha!
Left, right, left, right.
Can't take it anymore.
Nothing personal, I assure you.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Again and again and again.
Oh, a shame to let this beauty go wasted.
Gordius Freya!
The scout amongst. Neve stood silent. Suddenly.
Yes?
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Left. Right, left, right.
Watch your heads!
Again and again and again. Army's a waste of time for one like me.
Tiny metals. Hungry like a wolf, I am.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Feel any burning? See a local healer or wise one.
Thank you.
Oh, be a shame to let this beauty go to waste.
Left, right, left, right.
I only need corpses, except sometimes they're quite fresh.
Again and again and again.
And suffering. For what?
My pain serves a purpose.
Thing about slings. They hide well.
Use it.
to me! We'll not die this day!
I live to serve you. Without hesitation.
It's so dark and wet. Why is it everywhere we go is dark and wet?
Army's a waste of time for one like me. Left, right, left, right.
Make love, not war.
Again and again and again.
And just when you thought things were about to get dull.
Has today the day?
As you command.
Waiting for a personal invitation?
As ordered.
If the ring won't come off, just take the whole finger.
I think that's the last of them. But keep your weapons at the ready.
In her torch's feeble glow, the queen examined the beast's corpse. She could not help but to shudder in disgust.
Perhaps it's better,
she thought,
that we faced it in the dark.
At the corridor's end, they found a closed door. Before any could draw near, it opened with a crash. Beyond lay a circular room. Light shone through a hole in the chamber's ceiling, illuminating a stone pedestal and the sword that lay upon it.
The air in here, it crackles with magic,
whispered Ispel. Meave gripped the blade's hilt. A soothing warmth filled her arms and spread across her shoulders. Her tired muscles ceased trembling. Her fingers, stiff as sticks, relaxed. She brandished her prize, the air hissing as the blade sliced through it. She then nodded approvingly. The reward had been worth the risk. Barnabas Beckenbauer, a gleam in his eye, asked to look at the unsheathed sword. The gnome studied the quillions intently, having spotted an inscription there.
Can you say what's written there?
Asked Meave.
Yes, perhaps. They're clear, the words. Their meaning, not necessarily so. Wieldeth me and loseth not hope amongst the blood-red waters.
It sounds like a riddle that I've no wish to solve. We should move on, and quickly so.